Very much. I just I agree with what Claire said, most of it. Syria is a protracted problem now, crisis over the last 5 years. It is the only crisis that I myself, as a humanitarian worker, working for the last 35 years in humanitarian work, did not go to any camp because of what Claire said. Islamophobia, counter-extremism, counter-terrorism. If somebody sees me somewhere there, they might make a Photoshop with somebody else, and they could be making the news. This is how difficulty to work in an area like this. 2012, we wrote to the Charity Commission a letter about the number of emerging small Syrian organizations working in a conflict zone to give us a guideline, and the answer was, look at the website, which was not satisfactory. It's a challenging answer, because we as Humanitarian Forum or Muslim Charities Forum knew that the problem is happening, what will be happening. We learned from what happened in Afghanistan, listing of people, classifying people and organization. That's why we did not want to do the same mistake again. But the regulatory body has to do its own duty, really. Charities, not only Muslim charities, are doing, British charities are doing a great job in Syria with Oxfam, Save the Children, and others, plus the Muslim charities. We need to be recognized that we are going to counter extremism by helping people, not by stopping help. Claire talked about access. Access is not only the deliverable of food, water, clothes. It's access of your fund, which cannot be transferred to anyone. The banking. The banking industry is crippling the humanitarian work. The banking industry now stopping transfer to Turkey, not only to Syria, which leads to the cash in hand problem, which is happening. Happening because we are not logically sitting and thinking that we can empower our organizations. Syria as an issue has one solution, political solution. Political solution is the solution. And we as Britain or British government can do that with our allies. If we don't do political solution, we can have many, many pledging conferences for Syria, and we can talk about Syria in 10, 20 years' time. So political solution has to be done. Our government has to take its responsibility to do this. What Claire said is extremely worrying, because about 70% or 80% of the kids over the last 5 years are not in school. If I can give an example, in Lebanon, to enroll your children to the school, the father has to pay $200 for each member of the family. A family of five and six people, he has to pay $1,200 a year before the children being enrolled in any school. Those children could be the target for the extremist, the radical, and the terrorist organization. And we are still watching what's happening in Syria and complain about extremism, radicalism, and terrorism.
Thank you very much indeed, Dr. Hani. Omema.